I know the meaning of, you know, when you see something and it takes your breath away.
Right.
Because I've seen it happening. Mm. A lot of times when people look through the telescope and they can't speak.
Yeah.
They can't. I have to prod them. Dikha, did you see? And they come up from the eyepiece and they're sort of zoned out for like 5 seconds and this.
Yeah.
Ha, dikha, dikha. And,
yeah.
And then the addiction begins. Like, wow, that was something for you. That was
two
something
things, like space and marine life.
Yeah, both of them. So for me, the telescope is an aid to, you know, introducing people to the wonders of the universe.
Right.
It is not the main event.
Mm.
Okay. So I will usually not go above 4 to 5 objects a night.
Mm.
Okay. Because you're coming in for the first time, how will you recognize the other smaller, fainter?
You need to absorb it. Like,
you need to absorb it. So it's just like with everything. I need to feed you the easy bits first.
Mm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Once you understand and you appreciate the easy bits, you'll be ready for you know, something much tougher to see. For example, galaxies are very tough to see.
Mm.
Very, very tough to see. Mm. Now they say the closest galaxy to Earth is the Andromeda galaxy.
Yeah.
Okay, which is around 2 million light years away. But you but won't you understand that, it if you
need to say that name again.
The Andromeda galaxy.
How do you spell it?
A-N-D-R-O-M-E-D-A. So the Andromeda galaxy is around 2 million light years away. It's getting closer.
Yeah.
And you won't figure it out if you don't know what to look for.
Because maybe people have that Milky Way in mind, they are looking for that shape.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it does not appear to be in that very spiral form. It sort of appears like a faint wisp.
Hmm.
Yeah, that's how it appears. But the size is pretty large. It's almost as large as the moon in the night sky.
Okay, the size of the galaxy is as large
as the moon in the night sky. So they don't understand it.
Yeah.
So, and the second thing is when they look at the Milky Way, you know, we have all these beautiful, even I post those beautiful pics.
I've seen the shutter speed wala, star wala, sara that I've seen. Yeah.
So you've seen the Milky Way, which is
rising exactly.
I don't Photoshop my images,
right?
Which is to say that I don't add colors to the images, but I enhance the colors which are already there.
Right.
But when you see it, you require a really, really, really dark night where the temperatures are very stable.
Mm.
There's no humidity.
Right.
Then you'll start seeing some of the structures.
Mm.
Otherwise, people start seeing a cloud.
Mm.
Okay. And they can make out it's a cloud. And I've seen this conversation going on in, you know, a couple of my participants a lot of times. They look to each other. Oh, dekhna, wo badal hil hi nahi rahe hain. They think they're so udhari. Okay. And then when they come to the realization that, oh boss, ye badal nahi hai, this is the Milky Way. Then their minds are blown. Then there is wow. Wow. And once we start taking photos and we start showing it to them that, you know, this is how it looks through long exposure photography.
Yeah.
Again, their mind is blown. So it is something which is really, really, really exciting to them. The takeaway from this tip is that I do not want you guys to become rocket scientists. I do not want you guys to become astronomers. I want you guys to have a little more appreciation for the night sky than you had yesterday.
Right.
That's all I want. So that more generations can be exposed to it, because the night sky, astronomy, is what, in my opinion, kickstarted civilization.
Hmm.
Understanding the stars, looking at the stars for myths, understanding the seasons,
calendars,
everything.
Yeah.
It started there.
Right.
Okay, that is what helped you from going from a hunter-gatherer to a civilization that spans more than 7 billion people today. And it is a pity that more people don't get to experience it.
Yeah, and navigation aspect as well.
Navigation
just explored, it opened the world.
It opened the world up.
Yeah.
And today, when I really feel sad when most kids from Mumbai, from Pune, from Delhi, from Chennai, or Bengaluru, or anywhere else, don't know how the Milky Way looks like. They only understand or have never seen the Milky Way.
Right.
Or have never seen more than, you know, let's say 30 stars in the sky.
Hmm.
You should look at them. They become zapped when they come outside.